Okay, and this final group you see behind me is the Wind Symphony. Before we share their program, the last part of our evening, just a couple quick things. First, I mentioned large groups, something that a couple of the groups are going to, and not something we've been able to do the last couple years. But we did have a kind of a cool opportunity yesterday. We brought in a gentleman who kind of sat out here in the auditorium. We kind of did a mock run of our rehearsal, and he did what a judge would do at large group. He recorded himself kind of talking through the performance. He had scores so he could see what it was the students were supposed to be doing, made some comments, and then he's actually going to come back on Monday and come up and actually get a chance to work with the students. So we're very excited about that. It was Mr. Brian Stevens, who just retired from Dublin Jerome, fantastic band director. I actually student taught with him, I think it was about 4,000 years ago now. Just a wonderful man, and I'm excited for the students to get a chance to work with him. And he was very complimentary of all these young folks. So thank you guys for representing us so well to other folks throughout the Columbus community. We appreciate it. Also, a couple quick thank yous before we finish up our program. First, and I say this at every concert, we are so fortunate to work in a district that really values what we do, not just in their words, but in their actions. And so to Principal Brickley, to Superintendent Stewart, and the entire administration team, just help me give them a big thank you, please, for all the support they show. I will tell you that the fine arts area was a very difficult area to negotiate during the COVID world. And they had to make some difficult decisions that weren't always, that are never going to be popular with everybody. But I'm just so thankful that they always were putting students first whenever those decisions were made. So I appreciate it. And then finally, I do want to take just a moment of personal privilege. And I want to thank the teaching team that I get to work with. I've had to, unfortunately, miss a lot of school over the last several weeks. And Mr. Lai, Mr. Schultz, Mrs. Duvall, Mrs. Brokey have just stepped up and they make sure that these kids are taken care of. So will you help me thank everybody who I get to work with? All right. Finally, the reason we're here, we're going to finish up the program with the Wind Symphony. And I will just say this program is probably one of the most enjoyable ones that I've had the opportunity to work on, and I hope that you enjoy it as much as we've worked on it. This first piece, Overture to Candide, is fantastic. Do we still like it? Yes? Okay. I've heard more yeses than no's. I know you're going to love it. It is a very challenging piece, one of the more challenging pieces I've ever put in front of the Wind Symphony, and they are handling it with real maturity. So we hope you enjoy the entirety of our contest program, the Wind Symphony.
Thank you. supposed to talk with Schultz when he yells. But I do have one other person I have to thank. I forgot. We have, you might have seen this guy on stage a few times. He is not a triplet. Okay. He's just a wonderful musician. He's officially in symphonic band, although he plays some other instruments, so he sat in with Constant Winds. And then about 3 or 4 weeks ago, I found out that our bassoon player, Josh, is also a wonderful gymnast and is in another state right now performing a gymnastics competition. Because I had a big notice on this, I said to Mike, I said, hey, you want to sit in with Wind Symphony? And so in about 3 weeks, he's learned all of this material. And so I'll be thanking Mike.
Thank you.